It's news time. Information is power. Be current. The news headline. Igbos are very hardworking people. They are never lazy or sit at home. Kemi Olunloyo, a well-known investigative journalist, Kemi Olunloyo, has once again spoken. According to a tweet she made earlier today on her verified Twitter handle, she made it known that Indigo are very hardworking people, stating it clearly that they are not lazy and they don't enjoy sitting at home. Speaking further, the popular journalist made it known that Igbos are always working hard on a daily basis, stating it clearly to them that they should not, for any reason, listen to any daft political activists. That it is only those who are lazy that would continue to listen to the sit-at-home others, saying that the hustle of the Igbos are well known for, and that is why they excel in most of the things that they do. Also, Ejiofor, lawyer of Kanu, has spoken yet again.
As it will not entertain any excuse for his unavailability in court on Thursday, the Igbo lawyer said it is unlawful to detain an accused and at the same time vehemently refused to bring him before the court to look into the allegations leveled against him. In a statement signed and made available to journalists in Aba on Sunday by Barrister Victor Onwiremadu, coordinator of the Igbo Lawyers Association, and the secretary, Barrister Felix Jonathan, the group said that it is craving for justice and a fair hearing for Kanu and his release from detention without further ado. INA insists that Kanu has not committed any offense known to the law through his peaceful agitation, adding that the federal government have failed woefully to engage the IPOB leader and other agitators who called for self-determination. The group called on the federal government to take note that the Igbo Lawyer Association as a group will be sending a delegation of senior lawyers in solidarity with Mazi Nnamdi Kanu on Thursday in Abuja. Today, Northern elders have maintained serious influence and discreet bargain with the federal government to look into the demands of bandits Boko Haram and monstrous Fulani herdsmen. Attention is directly given to their demands, but IPOB doesn't deserve the mercy and attention of the government. Those effectively agitating or exercising their constitutional guarantee rights to self-determination are being killed like flies by the Nigerian security agents. Our people want to see Mazi Nnamdi Kanu hale and hearty on that day and consequently regain his freedom, which will substantially douse the rising tension in the southeast. And these are the Igbo Lawyers Association, who had again, joined their solidarity with Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, who is actually at the DSS facility awaiting trial, saying that in a statement signed by the journalist in Aba on Sunday by the barrister Victor Onwiremadu, who is actually the coordinator of the Igbo Lawyers Association, and also the secretary known as Barrister Felix Jonathan, where they say that they are craving for justice and fearing for Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, at least for his release from detention without further ado. They made it clear that there is nothing that he has done according to the constitutional law because it is his right for peaceful agitation, and therefore the federal government has failed woefully to engage Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, the IPOB leader, and other agitators who called for self-determination into dialogue, saying that they would send their senior lawyers to court on Thursday, October 21, 2021, in solidarity with Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, saying that the federal government, who ought to look into Boko Haram and the bandits and then some other Fulani ethnic killers, had actually shifted attention to the indigenous people of Biafra and other people who are calling for peaceful agitation for self-determination, saying that they are giving these terrorists attention discreetly, but the indigenous people of Biafra seems not to deserve mercy and attention of the federal government, saying that those who are agitating for their constitutional rights are actually guided by the constitution, and therefore the Nigerian security agency should stop killing them like flies, because they are going to ensure that Mazi Nnamdi Kanu himself regains freedom, which will substantially douse the rising tension in the southeast.
Struggle for Indigo, because charity they see starts at home.
And these were the words of Ike Ekweremadu concerning the ongoing mayhem in the southeastern part of the country, and also the detention of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, who is presently at the DSS facility, of which it was said that the federal government is fully aware of the October 24, 2021, which was actually a day that Mazi Nnamdi Kanu will be tried again at the court of law in Abuja. The lawmaker, that is his legal defense, the lead AGO4, actually says that as a result of the fact that the federal government knows that October 24, 2021 is the date, that nothing will actually stop them from presiding on that day, because it has been rumored that they are attempting not to bring Nnamdi Kanu to court that very day, seeing that as a result they have no logical excuse not to bring Uyedumazi Nnamdi Kanu to court on that Thursday, October 24, 2021, seeing that Mazi Nnamdi Kanu himself has actually begged millions of his friends and followers to continue to conduct themselves and operate within the ambit of law, as they have always done, seeing that more noticeable and commendable is the fact that their solidarity has stayed unbroken even in the face of all adversity, for which he is truly grateful. And therefore, Ekweremadu himself, which is actually a former deputy president of the Senate, actually called the Alaigbo himself that they need, especially those ones living in diaspora, that is outside the country, that they need to start speaking against violent agitations, saying that the lawmaker actually opened up this virtual lecture, you know, in South Africa, where he actually talked about this the Igbo in diaspora, a perspective which he delivered at the Igbo Heritage Lecture. During this lecture, he actually observed that a whole lot of worse things that could happen to Indigo at this time would be to their homeland to be turned into a battleground for another time in history, saying that it is imperative that the injustices and the marginalization that exist should be addressed, and in any case, they must ensure that there is stability of Igboland, because only in this way will the Igboland, which they call Alaigbo, be prosperous economically while also eliciting local and international sympathy and support for their predicament. In the past few months, they say that there has been a whole lot of mayhem in the southeastern region, and it was sacrosanct for the Igbos in diaspora and every other Alaigbo to support themselves towards exposure to liberal and progressive democratic ideals, as well as access to international resources, seeing that the many Igbo sons and daughters have actually been detained in various correctional facilities across the country, and the issues of the clampdown on unarmed protesters and the challenge of extrajudicial killings in Igboland in the most effective manner was needed, seeing that he assures them that the Southeast Caucus of the National Assembly is not resting on Mazi Nnamdi Kanu's case, because they are finding a political solution to his situation, and they appreciate their understanding.